it's CR again. This is the last video I'm going to create today for helping out some UW students. I want to give a quick, and there's many, many videos of this on YouTube, but we're just going to do a fast one about how to set up well if you're going to have to be presentable on a webcam. I'm sick right now, so this is my most basic setup. Usually I would recommend that you kind of do your hair a little bit nicer and neater, try to present it like you would at work. Make sure that you're wearing a full outfit. There are actually people that feel really uncomfortable with the idea that people might be wearing their like pajama bottoms below and a nice top up top. I don't personally care, but if your teacher or if your students do, that's something to keep in mind. But the main things I really want to point out are just the basic setups. Things I see a lot with people when they're doing a web kind of interface. First of all, we tend to look at ourselves. That's what I'm doing right now. Because we're trying to see what's going on. The other danger is if we're watching someone talk, we want to see their face. You might notice how right now this has a creepy effect. To make it look like you have eye contact, you want to position your webcam up towards the top, which I'm doing at the moment. And then what I recommend as a small hack is actually put the face you want to watch the most right under it. So you can still at least peripherally track that and look like you're making eye contact. Right. The other thing I want to note is that people oftentimes have a couple setups like this. So I'm going to move the webcam I have set up so you can see a couple limitations. So one I see very often is this right here. How awkward, right? So what that means is your laptop is pushed. Sorry, now it has to refocus on me. So it's a good example. Your laptop is pushed back a bit. Right? So you want to, when you set up, see, are people looking up at you in a kind of disorienting, disembodied way? Is your head cut off because the camera's pointing up to the ceiling and you're below it? Are you barely within the frame because you have the laptop pushed back far? Are you kind of here so they can see your mouth and your chin and your zits, but not necessarily your eye contact? You want to make sure that your webcam, if you have one, is set up on the top of your computer and a little bit above eye level, not at eye level, a little bit above. And that way you can angle it so it's looking down at you and you can get your full face in the frame and it's a little bit less disorienting for other viewers. I'm going to reorient this now. So for instance, this is about, if you look at my head right here, that's how far up above it is. You can just create your own setup this way. Take a bunch of books off your shelves and elevate your laptop and make sure that your screen is tilted in a bit toward you with your full face still on the screen. That's all you have to do. Right? The next thing you want to know is your space. You want to try to be in the middle of the frame. And you want to have kind of equal spacing all around. One of the mistakes I made in an earlier video today, for instance, I had this pointing so far down that I was kind of cut off, right? I had the other direction. Or you don't want to be like this close in. Like, hey, that's too close. That's really awkward. You want to have like a kind of reasonable proportion between your head and the middle of the screen, some of your shoulders so people can still catch your body language, your hand gestures, be far enough away and have some of the backdrop available. This is not an ideal backdrop setting, but there are a couple things that make it fine. One is there's a neutral color palette. I'm not distracting the other person with a lot of clutter and things and colors and things that people are going to find themselves needing or wanting to look at, especially if they have attention deficit, right? Something else to know is that I have a light that I've turned so that the light is at my face, not behind me. I also usually position myself in front of a window because nothing really beats natural light directly on your face if you want to make sure that you're visible to the camera. No matter how fancy your webcam, if you don't have adequate lighting, it's going to be fuzzy because it's not going to pick it up. So finally, you don't have to have good technology to do this, but if you know you're going to be doing a lot of online communication for the next several weeks and you have the resources in your department from your family or elsewhere, it's a good idea to go on and get yourself a basic $20 HD webcam that you can swap out your computer camera with. And what I like is just a basic Snowball blue mic. I think you can get them for 50. I get the condenser. But both of those things immediately help isolate the noise a little bit, bring your voice to the foreground, ensure that your face are the main things that the camera picks up. But that's like a under $100 basic setup. Home lamp, window, blue Snowball condenser mic, basic Logitech HD webcam. On the flip side, you can get rid of those things and it will be fine for most student environments. So I recommend setting your laptop up on a bunch of books so that it's elevated. Tilt your screen down a bit so that your whole face is in it, but it's not taking up the whole screen. Make sure you're looking up towards the camera lens and not just at yourself like you keep seeing me do while I explain it. Check your background settings. Make sure there's just no real distractions. Always have some type of light directly at you. It can just be a house lamp that's turned. You don't need a fancy setup. And then I recommend being in front of a window.